Hi guys, my name's Nick. Welcome to this episode of Connect. Today we're going to be going through a very cool e-lock demo, electronic door lock, that's based on the SimpleLink Bluetooth low energy hardware and software. I have David Lara here with me. He's on our Bluetooth applications team. Thanks for joining us, David.
Thank you for having me.
Yeah, I'm very excited to get into your demo. Before we kind of start, can you just talk to us kind of about the trend of electronic door locks and how we're seeing connectivity being added to the locks?
So something that it's very important to understand is that now everything relies on your phone, right? So now that you have your phone, you have connectivity, you have everything on your phone, it's something that everybody's trying to get access to, right?
Right.
In this case, e-lock is good at equipment for you to have connectivity, and then you can use your phone as a key.
Yeah. Yeah, and I've seen it, like, even at my place, installing an electronic door lock. I can open the door with my phone.
Exactly.
I can send keys to other people. It's very cool. And so this demo that you've created, it's based off SimpleLink hardware and software, and it demonstrates kind of an e-lock system based on BLE.
That's correct.
All right. Yeah, so can you give us a little look at what this demo is made up of, maybe a block diagram of what these components are?
Sure. Let's start with the main microcontroller. In this case, we're using a CC2642, and this one has Cortex-M4 plus BLE radio, and this one is connected to a CapTIvate device. This is an MSP430. It's connected through I2C.
And this CapTIvate device is the capacitive touch keypad.
Correct. That's a CapTouch, and this is the BoosterPack that you can see right over here.
Gotcha.
And also we have a QBJ display, another BoosterPack that is connected to my micro through SPI. And then that's pretty much it. So you get the input from the CapTouch, you process it, you send it over I2C, you can wake up the main micro, and then it will change the display on the screen. Plus, it would even send a message through BLE.
Okay. Yeah, and I'm sure people are tired of just hearing us talk about it, so let's fire it up. Show me what this can do.
Right, so let's start with the board itself, or the booster pack. And as I mentioned before, we have the booster pack, we have the LaunchPad, the CC2642 LaunchPad, and then the QBGA display booster pack. And in this case, we're using a very simple passcode that is 1, 2, 3, 4, and then you have to hit. And then at the same time, you actually looking at the screen, it's going to lock the screen, and then it's also going to send a message through BLE to refresh the screen on your phone.
So this is simulating the actual door lock that would actuate and lock, and then it updates over BLE onto your phone.
Exactly. So we're pretty much changing the motor through with the display.
Gotcha.
That's pretty much what you're trying to do. Now, the cool thing is that we can use all the features that, in this case, we're using an iPhone, right? So it works with my Touch ID. So when I go and just click on it, and then I put my finger on it, it's gonna lock. But at the same time, I can do double click on it, and then I can just put the same password, 1, 2, 3, 4, and it will unlock or lock.
Okay, so what happens if I try to unlock it with my...
Give it a try.
So how do I make the fingerprint?
Just click one.
Let's try again, no. All right, and then if I try to enter...
That's good.
Oh, so it gives me the buzzer. Okay, and then the correct password is 1, 2, 3, 4.
Right.
And then it unlocks.
And then try to put a wrong password on the board.
Okay, invalid passcode.
Right.
I will say this is the second demo, SimpleLink demo recently we've seen that has a 1, 2, 3, 4 type password.
I think it's very simple to yeah. use, right?
Yeah, but that's very cool. I can see how this is a good jumping off point to implement an actual electronic door lock with our BLE solution. So I'm sure that everybody watching is going to want to get their hands on this and get started. Is this stuff available on the web today?
Everything's available on the web. You have all the booster packs, the launch pads, and even the application that I'm using on my phone is available in the Android market and also on the Apple market as well.
Okay, yeah, and I know the 2642 is SimpleLink based hardware and software. The MSP430 is actually not a part of the SimpleLink platform. Can you talk about how the CapTIvate interacts with the SimpleLink SDK?
Of course. So we have been working with that group in order to create a plugin. So the plugin is it's going to be very beneficial for all the SimpleLink devices because they can easily just use this particular software, hardware, and then move it over to through all the devices that are part of the SimpleLink family.
Okay.
So it's just some software that we can reuse in all the SimpleLink devices, and it's, as I mentioned before, it's part of the plugin.
And we actually have an episode sitting down with one of our experts on SDK plugins discussing what those are. So if you're curious about the plugins, be sure to check that out.
Excellent.
But yeah, thanks for being here. David, thank you guys for tuning in. This is a very cool demo. Again, it's on TI's SimpleLink BLE solutions. If you want to get started, go to ti.com/BLE. You'll find some of these resources there. If you have any feedback on demos you'd like to see or topics discussed, you can tweet at us at SensorToCloud to give feedback about the show. And then again, we release these weekly, so be sure to tune in next week. We're sitting down with an expert. It's going to be something you don't want to miss. Thanks, guys.